Ladies and gentlemen, the men's final of the Dunlop British Open Manchester 2007. At the end of this final, ladies and gentlemen, we will have a new name on that magnificent trophy. We will join the names of Jonah Barrington, Jeff Hunt, the mighty Pakistanis Jahangir Khan and Jansher Khan, and more recently David Palmer and England's Nick Matthew. Our two finalists tonight are also from a new nationality. There has never ever been a Frenchman to win the British Open trophy. Grégory Gaultier and Thierry Lancou will be focused for that task tonight. Thierry Lancou, ladies and gentlemen, in the semi-final beat the world champion David Palmer in the semi-final. In 2006, he won in Canary Wharf. He won the Liverpool 08 event. He won the English Open and the Pakistan Open. In 2004, he was the number one in the world and he was the world champion. He was number one for more than 12 months. His opponent, ladies and gentlemen, Grégory Gaultier, is one of the fastest rising stars on the world circuit. He contested six PSA Tour finals in 2006 and won the Hungarian Open and the US Open. On his route to the final, he beat the world's number one squash player, Amer Shabana. Ladies and gentlemen, will you welcome, please, ranked number five in the world, from France, Thierry Lancou. And his opponent, ladies and gentlemen, tonight's final, ranked number four in the world, from France, Grégory Gaultier.
Well, welcome to the British Open final. Let me entertain you indeed. There is going to be a French name on the British Open trophy for the first time in squash history. And it's there's a lot of French people on our live chat. It's lovely to see. And for those of you who are watching, yes, we've had to drop the quality a little bit. We want to get as many people on. There's thousands watching. And I think the internet lines from France to England are absolutely red hot at the moment. Grégory Gaultier was ranked number two at his highest just a few months ago. And of course Thierry Lancou is a former world number one. Greg, only 24 years old, he's going to be around for many years to come. And there's a lot of people predicting fantastic things for Greg this season. He played brilliantly in beating Lancou 3-love at the US Open last year. I remember commentating on Nick Gregg's first win, and then of course he went on to win the title, beating Shabana in the final. And let's have a look at the past rounds for the players to get here. Let's see how they progressed through to this final. Gaultier had a comfortable win over Jonathan Kemp, only 30 minutes. In round two, Adrian Grant, and in three, Peter Barker, another Englishman. In all those matches, Gregg was well in control. And then a semi-final over Amer Shabana. Quite incredible match where Shabana, we've seen Grégory Gaultier beat Shabana in the past, but typically with a defensive lobbing game that's frustrated the Egyptian. Yesterday was very, very different. Greg attacked and beat Shabana at his own game, and I don't think I'd see anybody do that. And Amer went away, a rather disconsolate figure. I know Amer was struggling with an ankle injury on his left foot, and I'm sure that if you spoke to Amer, that he would have said there was that would have had some effect. But Gaultier made the final, and 208 minutes played on the clock. As for Thierry Lancou, probably the easiest first round match of anybody, 25 minutes over Mansoor Zaman, and to be honest, the scoreline flattered the Pakistani. In round two, Mohammed Abbas really gave Lancou a tough time. 9-all in the fifth.
Half time.
Before a mistake from Abbas, just laying up a simple shot from the back of the court that tinned, and that gave Lanku the little chink of light he needed to come through and win that match. It was a comfortable quarter-final against On Benghi, 61 minutes, with Benghi giving everything in the third to try and stay in the match, but Lanku just came through. And then last night, David Palmer, well, that was a strange match. Palmer was on fire in the first, and Lanku just couldn't live with him. And the second was something to behold, fantastic squash, but Palmer getting a problem with a muscle on his leg, his glute, he had a tear there, and he had to receive treatment in the third game, and it was really bad luck for David. He was definitely restricted in his movement, and although he managed a bit of a recovery in the fourth, and the fourth game was pretty special, the tension was incredible. As you can see, Thierry Lanku has, in the four matches, has only played 4 minutes more than Gaultier. They've basically been on for the same amount of time. Well, do come onto the chat rooms. Omar and Chris are live on chat, and they'll be talking online throughout the whole of this. And apologies if you did have a few problems getting here. We changed a few things last second on the server, so you're able to get in. Here are the head-to-heads, and Lanku leading 7-2. Well, actually, it's 8-2, because there's one missing off the bottom there, which was Lanku's win over Gaultier just a few weeks ago at the English Open. Lanku won 3-11, 11-8, 11-9, 6-11, 11-5 in 87 minutes, and that's another 3-2. It wouldn't be a surprise if this went to 3-2, in the same way that Thierry Lanku's British Open final from last year in Nottingham did. As you see, Greg has won two of the last four events meetings, though, in the US Open and at Saudi. So we have seen that Greg does have the ability to beat Lanku, and that's what makes this match so, so fascinating. Well, the players are having a nice long warm-up there. Lanku has been here for about 2.5 hours warming up around the place. We look at Gregory Gaultier's last 10 events. And as you see, he's had finals, he's done well, and that's why he's so highly ranked at world number four. He would be world champion if he'd have converted one of his six world championship points in that final against David Palmer. Of course, Palmer,
your officials for this
incredibly.
Match, in the centre, John Massarella. On the left, Roy Gingell. And on the right, Dave Atkins.
Palmer incredibly came back, of course, to win that World Open in Egypt. And Gaultier took the Hungarian, but the big one was the US Open for him, beating Shabana in that final. And as you see, a few more finals after that, a real purple patch for Gaultier. Four finals in five tournaments. And then two quarters at the Canadian, losing to Ricketts, and two defeats to White. And of course, just a few weeks ago, a defeat to Lanku at the English Grand Prix, who then went on to lose to Willstrop in the final. So, here we go, and John Mazzarella having a little chit-chat. I don't know if he knows that everybody can hear him. The whole audience are probably having a little giggle. Here's Thierry Lanku. As you can see, only once has he failed to get through to the quarter-final, where Rami Ashour knocked him out. World ranked number 21 then. Of course, he's now number 2. That brilliant match at Canary Wharf. We all watched it live. It's one of the most watched replays as well. A quite incredible match. It's available as a DVD also. And that match was fantastic, where Thierry looked to get through and then White suddenly came back. They're just having a final little knock-up. Just one quick last stat here before we get into the match. The graphs, the rankings of the two players going back for the last 4 years. As you can see, Gaultier's steep rise. And now, of course, he's the French number one. Since the beginning of this year, he has been highly ranked, higher ranked than Gaultier, than Lanku. But as you can see, Lanku twice has been world number one in two periods, at the beginning of 2004 and then for the whole of 2005. Well, with me,
the
I'm...
The final of the Dunlop British Open 2007 between Thierry Lanku serving, Gregory Gaultier receiving. Best of five games. Love all.
Well, with me, I'm very pleased to say, is Chief Executive of PSA and former world number four. You're sat in this chair as a squash fan, Gwaine Bryars. Welcome, Gwaine.
Thank you, Adrian. And here we have a very special occasion. Two Frenchmen, first time ever in the final of the grand old dame of squash, the British Open Championships. two similar routes to the final, one slightly older, Mr. Lankou at 31 years of age compared to Greg Gaultier, who of course is 24. The physicality of this match should be interesting. They're pretty much in the same position in terms of the amount of time they spent on court getting here, as opposed to last year when Thierry Lankou, of course, reached the final in a physical state of decline, terminal decline probably, by the time he got there, and really wasn't able to contest, although it was a marvellous effort in the final last year. This year, both of them very evenly matched. They know each other's games inside out. Great friends, great practice partners. Already cautious squash, down the lines, starting to test each other out.
This must be a fascinating thing, Wayne. Like when you were playing, there must be people that you have to come up against who you know so, so well. And that must be really tough, especially when it's a major final. And, you know, Greg was in Thierry's corner last night.
Yes, I must say these days players really help each other a lot on the circuit, and these two are very special friends. Nevertheless, one of them will be the winner. There will be no prisoners taken on this court. They'll be polite with each other, but it will be 110% to the end. Cautious early rallying, both of them feeling each other out already. Moving the ball to the back of the court, sliding that ball down the wall, a loose one from Lankou. In goes Gaultier with a straight drop. Another straight drop. And a third. Lankou asking for a let.
No let, no let.
No let given there.
Two love.
Thierry quite happy with that. It's he almost sort of... He's quite aggressive to the official and then sort of semi-apologises to Thierry. It's sort of almost he forgets that he's got Thierry on the other side, but he obviously has to play his natural game, doesn't he?
Yes, he does. Mr. Gaultier is no respect here of tradition. He is looking very sharp, very hungry. What a lovely back nick that was at the rear right-hand side.
Three love.
Lovely start here for Gaultier. Of course, we know that Lankou is the slowest starter on the PSA Tour. He typically loses his first game in lots of matches. Yeah, he wants a stroke here.
Yeah, the ball was wide.
Well, with his new three-man system, he may have been a bit fortunate there. But Gregory still got the upper hand. He has a mini break already. He's 3-0 up in the first to 11 scoring.
And Greg, who usually starts pretty well.
Yes, Greg's style is very much this beautifully floated, tight shots down the wall.
Yeah.
Another let ball.
And he does these shots as well. Malcolm's noticed this. He can vary the pace, which can really upset players at times. He's got this sort of little patter shot. It's an interesting serve there. You don't see that very often.
Lovely tight serve to the back. Brings the mistake from Lankou. Takes Gaultier to 4-love.
There's a big crowd here. Manchester Sports City. It's a fantastic arena, isn't it, Wayne? And I did some work recently on some squash video with Jahangir Khan and Jonah Barrington. Seen the days at... At Wembley Conference Centre, of course, where, you know, you were playing, you reached a semi-final yourself, didn't you?
I did indeed. Those were the good old days. Yes, I lost to the extremely nimble and fit Ross Norman, who was such a great player himself. At the moment, Gaultier has a nice 4-love lead, though. He's got off fast. I know that Lankou is a little bit slow on the start, but he can't afford to be too slow. Lovely cross-court shot, backhand cross-court deep into the court to give Gaultier a 5-love start.
What a start here for Gaultier. It couldn't have gone any better.
Down.
Commentator.
Unnecessary mistake there, sorry Adrian, from Gaultier. Allows Lankou in with his starting point.
And the ball's ball's out of court, they've got to go and find it. Lanku gets his first point on the board. He does admit himself that he's an incredibly slow starter, and it almost takes him a game to really get into it. And it's very strange psychologically, because he almost, although obviously he's not giving the game up, sort of mentally he knows he's slow, and you sort of see him come out so well in the second game. Five. It's almost as if he sort of mentally gives the first game up as because he is a slow starter.
Lanku is 31 years of age, and in squash terms, it's with respect, not he's no longer a spring chicken. But against Gregor Gaultier, you can't afford to give him too much of a start. And a lovely boast there from Gaultier moves around Lanku so well, forcing a boast from Lanku straight down the wall. Lanku's back in. They're back to their traditional play, up and down the wall.
Well, if you are watching this live, and we've got a lot of people on there.
Beautiful drop shot there from Lanku. Straight forehand drop, stretched right out. No response from Gaultier. Another
two
point
five
on the board for Lanku. Thierry taking his time again before serving. Nice tight serve, volleyed. Down the backhand wall we go again. These two are very... Oh, a lovely backhand straight drop shot cut into the nick by Gaultier. Adds another point to his inventory. Again, we see the patient rallying starting. Feeling each other out in this rally. A few cross courts straight down the wall there from both players on the forehand side. Cross court. Lanku straight down the backhand wall. Gaultier scrapes up. Lovely straight drop. Picked up. Cross court lob from Gaultier. Superb athletic movement from both players. Finished off with a lovely straight backhand drop into the nick from Gaultier to take him to 7-2.
7-2.
Again, Gaultier doing nothing too fancy, moving the ball around. Basic solid squash.
Down.
Oh, and a unforced error there from Gaultier allows Lanku another point.
Well, apologies for a few of you just had a problem getting in there. One of our streams just died there for a second. We just had to reset a few things. You've just missed Gregory Gaultier having an electric start, five love up. Very early on. Of course, these are two players who do know each other so, so well. Jahangir Khan's in the audience, which, of course, we're going to have a first name here on the British Open title, and there's a man in the audience who's won it 10 times. That was incredible. I watched a bit of that last week. Fantastic to see him win that 10th British Open title.
We've got some superb exchanges going here between the two Frenchmen. Lobs, counter lobs, and ultimately the stroke to Gaultier.
8-3.
And Lanku's not going to even argue that. I think mentally he's decided this game is already over.
I'm not sure about that yet, Adrian. He's still, but an unforced error. It could be the gap 9-3. Now at 9-3, maybe too much for Lanku to bring back.
See that there's a massive audience here in Manchester.
Overstretch by Lanku.
10-3.
Brings up the game ball for Gaultier after only 10 minutes.
Yeah, Lanku here just wasn't moving very freely, was he?
Oh, a careless shot there by Gaultier, allowing Lanku another point to four. Psychologically, of course, he's probably thinking the game's gone. What shall he do? Practice some shots, try, perhaps see if he can get into the legs of Gaultier before the game's gone.
Yeah. That's a very valid tactic, isn't it, Gwaine? And first game, you've got a good lead. Let's have a few long rallies. Let's punish the opponent. And I have seen occasionally a losing player just basically deliberately put one in the tin almost just to say, forget that, I'm getting off this. We're not going to have any tough rallies here when it doesn't matter.
Well, a beautiful shot there by Lanku, and it is Gaultier. His point. No, it's in the 11-4. Tin. That's the game to Gaultier. First game in only 11 minutes.
First game is over.
That's very, a major blow for Lanku. Yes, Gaultier will be exceptionally happy with that start.
Well, it's good to see there's a lot of people here. And it's a very busy night here on PSA Live. We've got a massive audience, and we are going to see a new name on the title. And who'd have thought that in the years when we saw the Pakistan dominance that we'd actually get a French name on there? What we're going to do, actually, just to let you know, for those of you watching, we're going to stop the bit rate here. We're going to actually just decrease it a little bit. I can just see that our serves are a little bit straining. There's so many people in there. So we're just going to cut things for a second. And we'll be back up very shortly for the start of the second game. Okay, here we are. We're back. We're live. This is Manchester. It's 9:20 in the evening. And Gregory Gaultier
15 seconds.
Is out very nice and early. He's a happy man. As he's very comfortably taken that first game. And Thierry Lanku, has he changed shirts already? He's really wasn't happy. He's doing something psychologically. He's now put a red shirt on, so...
Yes, Adrian, that was a strange first game for Thierry. He needs to raise his intensity now, because Gregory Gaultier is looking very comfortable. He's moving easily to all the shots that Thierry has played. Thierry has to find some magic and move this pace on substantially to start to make inroads into Gaultier's progress.
Gaultier leads, one game to love. Love all.
So on we go again, patiently down the backhand wall. These players practice this all day and all night. Clingers to the backhand side to force the weak shot. Yes, already I detect a bit more intensity from Lanku. He doesn't want to give any cheap openings to Greg. Something tells me that if Thierry is going to win this, it's going to be a very long physical match.
Yes, that's Thierry Lanku through and through, isn't it? He really does like to grind these ones out. Five sets doesn't scare Lanku.
Yes, lad.
A lovely shot on the wall from Gaultier, forced to scrape off by Lanku. Lucky to get away with just a let.
Let's just see it here. Look at that.
It's precision squash, using the side walls beautifully. Up and down the walls. Clinging shots. Yes, we're now settling into far more basic squash. Searching each other out. Counter drops, backhand side, a lovely cross-court lob. One of his trademarks from Lanku forces a lob return. Lanku is starting to dominate the Timor now. But a weak cross-court straight onto Gaultier's forehand volley. Punished down the wall. End of the rally. Gaultier still moving very smoothly. On the tee again, volleying. Lankou behind him, trying to get the ball past him. Yes, a simple yes, left.
One love. Left.
It does look at this moment that Gaultier is looking the more comfortable of the two. Thierry searching, trying to find some way to penetrate Gaultier's armoury and get some points on the board. Lovely working boast by
and out.
Lankou followed by the drop. We go to the patient rallying. Forces the boast. Lovely feinted drop from Gaultier. What a shot. Faces the other way. And plays and the straight drop on his forehand. At this moment, both players again now jopping for position around the tee. Lovely tight shots down the walls. Conventional squash. But a lovely straight drop from the back of the court forces a counter drop from Gaultier. Forehand volley cross court. Lankou gets it back. Back to the wall play.
Really tight play here.
And a lovely backhand boast from Gaultier. Too far for Lankou to stretch.
Here's a replay. And Greg. Well, I think he's had many months of following Lankou. He knows that Lankou's going to come at him like a steam train in this game. And this could be the match hanging on this game. If Greg down. Can handle it. Oh.
Completely unforced error there by Gaultier. Possibly gives Lankou some hope. When you analyse their progresses through this tournament to the final, Gaultier, of course, who seems to be developing a sign on the current world champion, Amer Shabana, taking him out in a majestic 3-1 semi-final. Lankou with a much more rugged match against the never-say-die David Palmer. But a match that wasn't... Oh, a completely unforced error there on the backhand side from Gaultier. Is he starting to himself show some signs of strain? Back we go to developing the rally. Patiently down the walls. Wide cross courts. Creating the openings. This is no shootout. This is two players at a lovely... And will that be a let?
No let.
Slightly unlucky, I believe, but still, it was a beautiful forehand volley from Gaultier.
Lankou takes one in the head there. He just shouted out that I'm trying to play. Bit unlucky there, Lankou. Really took a right jab there. It was like being in the ring with Mike Tyson for a second.
And a beautiful clinging shot from Lankou on the backhand. And forces an error off the wall from Gaultier.
Really tight now. 4-4, second game. Next few points are massive. Both these players know it.
Thierry Lankou starting to move around the court with more assurance. Down the backhand wall they go again. Cross court from Lankou. You get the feeling that Lankou is starting to engage. To the cat and mouse, all within one rally. Attack, counter-attack in cat and mouse. both players back to feeling each other out within the same rally, up and down the wall patiently. Great pickup there from Lanku, and again.
Down.
And Lanku forces the unforced error from Gaultier, who perhaps loses patience at the end of the rally. This is probably the way Lanku will have to concentrate and focus on playing for the next hour and a half if he's going to win this title.
Just wrong on the score for a second there. 5-4 to Lanku. What a rally. Look at look at how hard these two are breathing. That's taken a lot out of both players.
Yes, we must remember that it's one thing getting to a final, it's another thing playing it. The huge amount of adrenaline these two players will be pumping out having got here. This is their one opportunity. There will only be one winner, one name on that fantastic trophy. And a beautiful working drop from, and a cross-court slider from Gregory Gaultier.
And
forehand
out.
Cross-court. Too good for Lanku.
Five all.
Brings the score up to parity. Both players building the rally again. Both trying to dominate the team. Some traffic issues in the middle of the court, but they are working around each other. A lovely backhand drop from Lanku forces a beautiful high lofted return from Gaultier. You can see how well these two know each other's game. Carefully feeling each other out down the walls. Lovely tight positional play and a beautiful backhand drop shot into the straight nick from Gaultier. Takes him to 6-5 in the second game.
6-5.
Fantastic play here from Gaultier. Apologies for a few of you who've had a few problems. We had a server disconnect on us for a second there, so we had to go back out, come back in. This is crucial points you're joining us at.
Thierry Lanku still playing a basic condition game. He needs to up his intensity. He needs to find something a little different because Gregory Gaultier is looking very comfortable and moving his opponent around the court.
Fierce rally.
Both players demonstrate that crab-like cross-court movement to volley the ball. Lovely boast there from Lanku, forces a superb log back from Gaultier, and a terrific deep length gives the point to Lanku.
Hand out, 6-6.
Key point here for Lanku. A difference between 7-5 and 6-6. You see there's a sigh of relief on Lanku's face as he realised Gaultier wasn't going to get that one back. These are fierce rallies now on court. 6-6, second game.
Yes, a loose man. Shot six from four. Lanku. Rather fortunate, I believe, to get away with just a let there. Gaultier looking a little nonplussed by that decision.
Yeah, he's staring at the officials here, but of course there's three of them to stare at.
A solid working shot. Oh, and a bit of a lazy cross-court backhand volley by Gaultier. Perhaps indicating for the first time a slight weariness.
Yeah, it's Greg, of course, did have a tough match yesterday in the semi-final.
Oh, and another mistake by Gaultier. Some would say a sitter.
Yeah.
8-6.
Real opportunity here for Greg.
This is a mini break for Lanku. 8-6 up. He needs to capitalise now on this and move forward to close out the game.
8-6. He was 6-5 down. He's 3 points in a row. Yes,
forces let. Another. Oh, only eight, a let.
Six. Yeah, I think it was so high.
A beautiful straight drop he played.
Greg mimics Lanku a little bit here. Noticeable at the English Open, actually, that... two players didn't get on too well on court, which was quite interesting. There was they had disagreements.
Yes,
And there we have that movement, that specific French movement that Lankou shows, where he moves pretty directly straight back at the opponent. I think he's fortunate to just escape with a let on that. Back to the patient, up and down the wall play, trying to get the opening. A beautiful post from Lankou, cross court from Gaultier. Back to the basic play, another lovely post from Gaultier. Volleys down the wall again on the backhand side. Real cat and mouse squash going on here. Forces a back wall return from Lankou. Lovely drop, Lankou onto it at the counter, and he just clips the top of the tin. 7-8.
And out. 7-8.
Here we are back to live. Really tense stuff here. Who will be the first Frenchman to win the British Open?
We know that Lankou has an enviable record of coming from two love down in matches, but something suggests to me he can't afford to go two love down tonight to Gregory Gaultier. This young man looks hungry, inspired. He's on a mission. He's prepared to play tight and the long game. Oh, and the unforced error from Gaultier gives Lankou a 9-7 lead.
Hand out 9-7.
Some real tension out on court there. Both players just feeling it a little. It's been a long week. This is their fifth match in 5 days. And Gaultier did have to work very, very hard. Oh, lovely shot.
Hand out. 8-9.
Beautiful cross court backhand volley dying over the 17-inch tin from Gaultier. Pulls him back. This is nip and tuck all the way up to the end of the game. 8-9, hand in to Gaultier. Back they go to the patient rallying, seeking a lovely tight shot from Gaultier. Cross court from Lankou, scrapes back from Gaultier. Into the back of the court they go, and traffic problems.
8-9.
No. That's a stroke!
No.
What are you doing?
Unanimous decision on a let.
Yes, a unanimous decision from the three-man refereeing system. There can be no argument with that. The match nearly half an hour old. The sweat pouring from both of them. The intensity, Adrian, as you say, is huge out there. Lovely backhand drop from deep court. Gaultier straight up like a viper attacking that cross court. But back they go. Up and down the backhand wall, patiently. Beautiful backhand drop from Gaultier. Pumps his fist in the air. This young man is really demonstrating the intensity to take the title.
9-9.
What a comeback here. He's such a fighter, this kid. Never believes the game is up. Nine all, second game, massive now. 2-love lead for Gaultier, make him a massive favourite. It's all down to the next couple of points.
We know Lankou is a fantastic fighter, and he may not have many more opportunities. We're back to the basic, the grinding squash, a lovely volley, that's going to be a let.
Yes, let. 8-9 all. Left.
Little apology from Greg towards Thierry. Thierry handles left. This issue by really not responding at all to Greg's comments. Greg does try and have communication with his countrymen, but Thierry, I think, handles it very much as he likes to handle all his matches, really. Keeps himself to himself. You were watching yesterday, Gwen. Yes, you saw the issue with Palmer accusing Thierry of wetting the ball, and then Thierry's response was to blow on his hand, and he was blowing on the ball. It was It's the first humour I've seen from Thierry on court in several years.
Well, that was a very amusing passage. I'm not sure if Thierry was, in fact, just trying to get his hand dry, but of course, these guys would never deliberately wet the ball. No, we're back to basic squash here. Lankou maintaining his rhythm, looking to keep his opponent deep in the court, seeking a turning. Interesting moment for the referees.
Yes, let. No.
Gaultier's out of the court, gesticulating. He can't believe it.
Greg is a funny chap. We just missed what he said there, but the whole audience burst out laughing.
Left side.
Well, the tension's high. This is a critical juncture. 9-all. One left to Gaultier. Lankou has to knuckle down now. He has to try and win this game somehow.
We could hear them just talking, actually. On.
A lot of chit-chat going on.
Yeah, 9-all. Play on. Yes, thank you.
We can just hear, actually, Gwain. Our French viewers can actually hear what's being said, although I think they have now decided to... That's the first time Thierry's actually responded. And what, you know, I just said that Thierry's one who likes to keep himself to himself, but he was so annoyed there.
Whatever was said, I know Kander forces the backhand drop mistake from Gaultier to give Lankou game ball.
10-9, game ball.
What a massive mistake this was. And here we go. Gaultier's gone off the serve.
And a tin forces the tiebreak.
Hand out. 10-all. Tiebreaker. Player to win by 2 clear points.
The audience here are absolutely loving this. What an atmosphere.
There's so little in it between these two players. Hardly surprising. They practice together all the time. They're the best of friends. But at the end of the day, one will become the British Open champion. Let ball there. Another traffic issue. Again, demonstrating this individual sideways movement that the two players both have.
Stats on the screen. Career tiebreaks. Gaultier has 60% and Lankou 62%. So they're neck and neck, even on tiebreaks.
Couldn't be closer.
Yes, right. 10-all.
Simple let. This is a result of the two players focusing even more on playing tight up and down the backhand wall and trying to seek the slightest bit of an opening. Good cross courts from both players. Good drills down the line. Patiently, that's going to be a stroke.
Yes, let.
That's a surprise.
Ten all.
In the middle!
No, it's not. It's wide. It's wide.
It's wide?
Yeah.
Well,
it's
I have a sympathy
decision.
With Lankou on
it
that shot.
It is a unanimous decision.
But
all
it was
three
a unanimous
of us.
Decision.
Yes, let. 10-all.
Mental focus is absolutely crucial now between these two players. Who's going to keep themselves under control more? Loose shot. Gaultier's on the tee volleying. Lankou's got back in. He's placing the ball down that wall again on the backhand. Lovely tight shots. Down the wall they go. Loose shot from Gaultier. Forces a slight attack from Lankou, but down the rail they go again. And a lovely backhand drop from Gaultier forces the cross court lock from Lankou. Down the forehand wall.
I think this actually touches Lankou. On the way through.
Yeah, stroke to Gaultier.
It's unfortunate, but it was such a wide shot from Lankou that Gaultier clipped him on the ball as it went through to the front wall. That's a stroke to Gaultier, giving Gaultier a game ball to go two games to love up.
11-10.
Lankou not happy there.
Game ball.
And is there an etiquette there? Should Gaultier have not played the shot?
I'm afraid it's Gaultier's... choice to hit the front wall. He's entitled to see the whole of the front wall. I have seen players in the past hit those balls very hard. But we have an amazing moment of sporting gesture here from Gaultier, who's agreed to play a let.
Well, that's incredible.
10-all.
What a time to do it. He's happy with the let. He obviously it would have eaten him up inside to have taken that when he really shouldn't have played the shot, perhaps.
Yes,
incredible sportsmanship. He could have gone two games. We'll stay alive. 10-10.
Down.
Gaultier just clips the tin on the backhand side.
And out, 11-10.
Giving Lankou opportunity for a game ball.
Well, is Greg going to be regretting that point he decided to give back? We'll see. Thierry will play a very tight game. He's pushed Greg to the back now.
Thierry starting to dominate the tee, looking to volley more. Lovely straight backhand drop, exchange backhand drop. Lovely pick up again from Gaultier on the wall. Cross courts.
What a rally.
Back down the wall, deep again they go. Lovely straight drop from... And he hits an incredible, lucky, deep nick on the cross court, giving Lankou the game. One game all. We've got
game
a real match on now.
12-10. Games are one all.
Game is on. And that was a crucial, crucial point. Incredible for Gregory Gaultier to give away that point that he'd been given as we look at the graph for the second game. And there you see Gaultier was it was pretty neck and neck. Gaultier led early on. Lankou managed to have a lead as we got towards 9-7. It was up to 9-9. Gaultier had a game ball at 10-9. And then at 10-10, Gaultier hit Lankou, just glanced him on the side of the leg, and he actually then decided to just play a let, not take the point. And that's quite incredible, isn't it, Gwen? What sportsmanship.
Adrian, I haven't witnessed a sporting gesture like that in a major final. I'm not sure if I've ever witnessed anything like that. And as you say, will Gregory Gaultier live to rue that decision? Nevertheless, I suppose it just exemplifies the kind of spirit and gamesmanship, or sportsmanship, should I be saying, in which the top players these days play with. It's really quite remarkable.
Well, we're looking at the past performances at the British Open. We're looking at Gregory Gaultier. I'll just refresh this page. This is what Greg's done at British Open in past years. Two quarterfinals and a second round. And, of course, Palmer put him out first time round. Jonathan Power in 2005, incredible match that was, five-setter. And then a five-setter against Thierry Lankou last year in the quarter. And of course, Thierry then went through to the final just to dip out to Nick Matthew, when you had to be fair that Thierry's legs were probably a little bit sore after five sets with Gaultier, five sets with Palmer in the semi last year, and then he was up against Nick Matthew. Here's Thierry Lankou's form at the British Open. Of course, many semi-finals and two semis, a quarter and a final, and look at the quality of player it's taken
seconds
to put him out. Martin Heath, when Martin was really in his pomp in 99, Power, Nickel, Shabana, Nickel, and then that final against Matthew. Thierry's been a class act here at the British Open, and some would say he's possibly one of the best players to have actually never won the British Open.
Yes, something tells me that Gregory Gaultier will definitely have his day. That said, we do have a new meteor on the horizon called Rami Ashour. But that's another story. At this moment in time, Thierry Lankou, I believe, is desperate to win this title. He's come so close last year, as I mentioned. He must have been in a terminal physical condition by the time he got to the final, yet he still put in the most incredible performance to lose to Nick Matthew in that amazing match in Nottingham. But here we go again. Yep. One game all.
Well, for those of you watching live, do bear with us. I think everything's working just about okay. We've got so many people watching. It's incredible large numbers. And we've got a team of several people in the background putting bits of string together, making sure everything works okay. And got 95% of you are watching fine. And of course, there will be replays available later on as well. That was a lovely shot.
Unfortunate for Lankou, he played a very good rally there.
And out.
Just a slight loose one here. Caught the sidewall, allowed Gaultier to play a superb backhand boast.
Yes, we This is the biggest ever audience for a live squash match on the web. I reckon there's a few thousand people watching this. It's quite incredible. I know that the whole of Pontefract Squash Club will be watching this. And, okay, that's... I don't know how many people will be in the club at the moment, but let me know on chat.
The ball seems to be lively. Both players moving very early on here, looking to get an advantage, looking to volley. Bit more French cat and mouse here. Down the wall, cross-court lobs. Down the wall again on the forehand. Cross-court, lovely backhand drop shot from Gaultier. Counter-drop, counter-drop again. Straight onto the racket. That's an interesting decision.
Yes, lad.
Slight collision there. Best of friends.
And Thierry sees the funny side of it. Well, he's out the door again.
No, the ball was too deep, and it is a unanimous decision as well.
Now we have the famous unanimous decision. There's nothing really to argue about there.
It's unanimous, Mr. Gaultier. No, my two assistants agree with it.
Three left for this.
If I was Lankou, I'd be thinking.
Just settle down, please. And the
my
right
opponent
side,
is starting to get a bit fired up here. Suggests he's not quite as comfortable as he may seem. Thierry back to focusing so well as he does, keeping quiet, keeping away from this action.
Thank you.
I just listened to him talking French. I don't think there's been a better humoured British Open final in its whole history. These two are having a bit of a party out there.
A lovely forehand sliding cross-court kill. Racket face open, bringing the ball down sharply across the floor. No chance for Gaultier. Back to the straight drop exchanges on the backhand side. Gaultier fishing a little for a stroke there. But Lankou comfortably back in, cross court. Hits it onto himself. Lankou 2-1.
You don't see the ball carried?
The ball was good.
Of course.
2-1.
Seems to me that Thierry Lankou is looking slightly more comfortable at this stage. He's starting to dominate the tee a bit more. Lovely and a beautiful volley there from Gaultier. Yes. Seeking the let.
Yes, let. 2-1.
A few oohs and ahs from the crowd here. They're really getting into this match, aren't they?
Well, Gregory Gaultier is not quite playing with the same assurance as he did in the first game. Thierry Lankou is definitely now much more of a player in this match. As you can see from the camera positions, Lankou is dominating the tee far more at this stage. Moving the ball to the corners. Moving Gaultier to the corners. Lovely backhand drop exchange again between these two, but what a clinging shot there. Catching the nick and a backhand straight drop. Beautiful. What a wonderful exchange at the front. And a beautiful clinging backhand drop shot from Gaultier. Gives Lankou no chance of a pickup.
And out.
Absolutely jammed into the sidewall. Years of practice. What a fabulous return off service there from Lankou. You can't afford to let up concentration for a second.
3-2.
Allows him to push to 3-2 ahead in the third game. Gregory hitting that ball harder, looking to add a bit more pace. What a fabulous deception from Gaultier. Shows the feint one way, then literally semi-lobs the ball down the forehand wall. No chance for Lankou to pick that up.
Back to live now.
And another superb backhand drop shot from Gaultier, clinging right up into the wall there, allowing Lankou no chance to recover the shot. This match is ebbing and flowing, just as one player starts to look comfortable. And that's another stroke brought on by a superb shot by Lankou at the front forehand corner.
And out. 4-4.
The arguments are getting more frequent. The intensity is rising. Thierry happy to slide the ball deep, not allow his young opponent the chance to sprint into the front left corner where he's so effective. Down the walls we go again.
Down.
And he's just clipped the tin. It's another point to Lankou. Psychological break to go 5-4.
Down.
A careless shot there from Lankou. Boast, backhand boast that clips the tin. It's 5-5. It's neck and neck. Very difficult to see who's going to break free at this moment in the match. And another superb shot down the backhand wall from Gaultier. The most simple things are the most effective.
6-5.
No chance for Lankou to scrape that off the sidewall. Fairly loose play on the forehand. Now tightening up again. Real attack coming in from Lankou, but a beautiful backhand drop. And fantastic shot play from Gaultier. Slides his backhand cross court. Two bounces before the sidewall. No chance there for Lankou to gather that up.
Both players totally settled on this court now. We're seeing the best squash that they've got to offer us. 49 minutes.
Gregory Gaultier is hunting that ball. He's now volleying more. He's picking that beautiful backhand exchange going across. Gaultier puts a fantastic straight forehand drop shot in. Again, glued to the sidewall. Thierry has no answer to that.
8-5.
Another critical juncture in this match. Gaultier now 8-5 up. 3 points from a 2-1 lead.
Gaultier, 4 points in a row. He was 5-4 down as well, remember.
How can Lankou respond? Patient rallying down the wall is his mantra. But Gaultier, volleying.
Down.
Careless shot into the tin.
And out.
Brings Lankou to 6-8. Both players again into the rallying, up and down the backhand wall, cross court there. Down the forehand wall, Gaultier volleys. Lankou picks up, delivers the ball to the back of the court. Traffic issues in the front of court. A lovely backhand drop. Pick up straight down the wall. Gaultier's to it. On they go. Up and down the backhand wall again. Beautiful tight shots. Looking to volley. Another super and a fantastic backhand drop from Gaultier. Provides the error again from Lankou.
And out.
Takes him to 9-5. So close to the second
9-6.
Game.
9-6.
Yeah, we're just a little bit behind on the score there. It's 9-6. Two more points for Gaultier. You could see that was a massive point for him. Let out a shriek of excitement.
How can Lankou respond? His trademark patience. High cross court deep. get his opponent into the back of the court. Down the wall he goes again. But Gaultier is down. With it. And a careless mistake there from Lankou, cross-court into the tin.
10-6, game ball.
Brings up the game ball for Gaultier to take a 2-1 lead. Fantastic exchange at the front of the court. Both players, cat and mouse. What a fantastic, again, drop shot from Lankou. Gaultier to it, cross court. Another drop shot from Lankou. Volley cross court. Gaultier onto that too, keeping himself on the tee. Superb play from both players.
Game to Gaultier.
Unforced error comes from Lankou.
He leads 2-1.
Gaultier takes the lead. Goes out 2-1 up.
Well, what a game. And Gaultier, he fought Lankou hard in the second. But he's managed to get that lead again, as you see, from 6-6. It was neck and neck all the way through, swapping leads. And then a run of 4 points for Lankou. For Gaultier, he was 5-4 down to go 8-5 ahead. Fantastic play from the Frenchman, from the French number one. There's a slide here which is always interesting. We go back to past recent winners of this tournament. And look at this, we go back to the days Jan Chacon won it. It's 6 times in a row. And beating Rodney Isles, Peter Nicol in 97. That famous win for Nicol over Jan Chacon in 98, which is available as a replay now in our archives. You can watch that match again. In fact, quite a lot of the older matches are there now from some of the biggest tournaments on the tour. John Power beating Peter Nicol up in Aberdeen. I remember being there for that one. Peter having to retire, unfortunately. He was not a well man. In 2000, David Evans at the NIA. Fantastic victory over Paul Price. And in 2001, that win with Palmer over Chris Walker. Chris Walker did an incredible thing. Came through qualification, beat everybody through to the final, and was 2 love up. And then just ran out of steam. And I remember Palmer cut out his errors. He tinned an incredible number. I was there doing the stats for live television, and
15 seconds.
The errors from Palmer's racket were incredible. 2002, Peter Nicol beat John White to take his second British Open title. And then getting into more recent years, Palmer taking his second and third titles in 2003 and 4. 2004, of course, was Nottingham. Fantastic venue there at
Time.
The Albert Hall. In 2005, we were here, where Ricketts beat a very tired James Willstrop, who did his best, but he just didn't have the legs after an incredible semi-final win over Jonathan Powell that went to 5. And then last year, as we saw, Nick Matthew beating Thierry Lankou in 5. And that was after Lankou had 5 setters against Gaultier in the quarter and Palmer in the semi-final. One of the questions that comes up sometimes, Gwaine, which is about... It's not always about the final. Sometimes if you've had a really tough quarter or a semi, you just haven't got it in the legs the next day.
Yes, of course. I've heard this many times, but then if you cast your mind back to some of the great players in the past, they have trained themselves to play 3, 4, 5 matches, brutal matches in a row. So ultimately it'd be nice to have a day's rest, but at this level, in this sport, the players are prepared to play at the highest level several times in a row. If Thierry Lankou is to win this title, he must regroup himself and start playing a more fundamental, conventional game, and that's going to be a stroke.
Stroke to Lankou.
No.
An appeal on the ball. The ball was good.
The ball's called good. Lankou takes a very important
and
psychological
out.
Early point.
1 love.
As I was saying, it's my view he needs to straighten up. He needs to contain his younger opponent. At the moment, the game is too all court. It's too many boasts, too many drops going in. Gregory Gaultier is loving that type of play. It has to be the long, hard haul for Lanku if he's to come through.
Well, unfortunately, both players wearing white now, so a little bit more difficult to tell. With black shirt, I think the man with the long socks is Lanku. That's his trademark now.
What a superb backhand volley drop from Gaultier. Reflex movement.
And out. One all.
Brings him to one all. Match is still not quite an hour old, but the adrenaline these two players will have been pumping.
Down.
Look at the stretch on that movement. Lanku looked for a second, tired there.
2-1.
He wasn't fully committed to that return. Gaultier takes an early 2-1 lead. Lovely drop shot 3-1. From Gaultier. Lanku doesn't respond. Signs are looking ominous for Lanku.
Yeah, absolutely. Thierry.
Oh, and a tin from Gaultier just when he needs to maintain his momentum.
Isn't it incredible how often that happens? Just Greg just relaxing possibly a little bit.
Superb craftsmanship in the front left-hand corner again.
Greg finally gets a stroke. Thierry's not happy about this.
4-2.
Look how tight that ball was again from Gregory Gaultier on the side wall. Again, the simple things produce the best results. Affords Gaultier a 4-2 lead in the fourth game.
Well, David Palmer was complaining yesterday about Lanku pushing him around a little bit, trying to manufacture the odd stroke. And I think Lanku was just saying the same to Greg there.
Yes. Things are getting critical in this match. And a lovely straight backhand drop. Open face, cut down into
and
the
out.
Front left-hand side of the court
three,
from
four.
Lanku. Pulls him back to 3-4.
Lanku's really pumped here. Look at his reaction here. He's very, very serious.
Look, he's blocking me on the way.
He's not there. No let.
Surprising decision. A no let given. Gaultier goes
and
to 5-3.
Yeah, just the referees at this tournament have been giving
5-3.
No lets, I feel, just a little bit more than usual. They're really rewarding the good shot, but I think there's been a few occasions where the top players have been saying, well, even though it was a good shot, I'm still going to get that one back.
Some lovely interplay again going. How tight are those shots on the wall? Both players now back down the rail. A loose one from Lanku, but he's back in with a straight. Seeking the let.
Mr.
No
White,
way through.
Just be careful with the physical, please.
No,
I'll give the decision without the physical contact. No let.
He's blocking so hard.
6-3. It was a unanimous decision on the no let there.
It's a no let. There's no way back for Lanku on that. He must regroup now, control himself, focus on what he's going to do with the next shot.
Yeah, it's a crucial little period there. 2 points there.
Another weak shot from Lanku, but he's back in. It's down the wall again with Gaultier on the forehand side, but Gaultier still volleying. A beautiful backhand drop picked up there by Gaultier. Volleys it down the wall.
Out.
And the ball is out. Gaultier really in the ascendancy now. Moves
right
to 7-3.
7-3.
Critical time for Lanku if he has to have a chance of hauling this back. Down the wall, backhand side. Both players again starting to work the rally to build it. Perhaps too early there by Lanku. Down the wall on the forehand side. Gaultier moving still very quickly into the front of the court. Down the forehand wall they go. And a loose one there from Lanku. Fortunate that Gaultier didn't make more of it. Slightly loose period in this rally. But back down the backhand side they go. And a boast from Lanku. Guesses for the cross court. Doesn't get it. Still retrieves a lovely backhand drop shot again from Gaultier, leaving Lanku completely frustrated.
8-3.
Though the weakness of Lankou's shot allowed Gaultier the position to play that superb backhand straight drop into the nick. 8-3. Things are looking ominous for Lankou at this position.
Yes, Thierry looking very disappointed here. He feels that he's been bullied out of this a little bit in this game. He wants to try and play squash, but it's just not happening at the moment. And Greg looking very fresh.
Greg is playing with such self-assurance in both the front corners. He's forcing errors from Lankou. Lankou needs to get out of those corners and keep his opponent deep. Patient squash is the only way back. What a beautiful down drop shot again from Gaultier. He's untouchable in the front left-hand corner.
Right side, 9-3.
That is just too good. Gaultier is 2 points away. We've played 2 minutes over the hour. The writing's on the wall here. Wonderful length and a brilliant drop shot.
Fabulous backhand volley drop from Gaultier into his trademark position there.
10-3.
Brings him to championship point.
24 years old. How many more British Opens will this young man win? He's got 7 championship balls.
Lankou down the backhand wall, cross court. Gaultier onto it. Volley cross court from Lankou, straight volley. Oh, and he casually flips it into the cross court, Nick, to give him the championship. 3-1 to Gaultier. What a fantastic performance by the young Frenchman to take the title for the first time.
Game and match to Gaultier. 11-4, 10-12, 11-6. 11-3.
Ladies and gentlemen, congratulations to Gregory Gaultier becoming the British Open champion. But your appreciation, as always, to his opponent, Thierry Lankou. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. We would be grateful if you could retain your seats while we make the presentations. Following a little interview with Gregory, if we can get him courtside. Ladies and gentlemen, just waiting while we're waiting for Gregory to come back to his chair. We are proud and very pleased to announce that the High Tech World Squash Championships 2008 will be played in Manchester from the 11th to the 19th of October. The partners are High Tech, the North West Development Agency, UK Sport, Manchester City Council, the Manchester Evening News, Dunlop and England Squash. The website is www.worldopensquash2008 and the tickets are on sale from 9 a.m. in the morning. So, ladies and gentlemen, the High Tech World Open Squash Championships here in Manchester in 2008.
Well, we'll just wait for... we're going to hear an interview here first.
Young man, many, many congratulations. I don't really think I need to ask how much this means to you. I think that was self-evident yesterday when you got through from the semi-final to the final. So, tonight, the first Frenchman ever to win a British Open title.
Yeah, I almost want to cry. It's crazy. Yeah, it's unbelievable. This is one of my dreams to win this title. This is after the World Open. This was my target, my second target. So it's my biggest win ever at the moment. So I'm so pleased. I'm so pleased to be back playing well, playing the level I always wanted to play. I had such a tough time the past 6 months with a very bad injury, and I know some people know what he is about. I'm happy for Thierry to be back as well. Last time he beat me, this time it's me, so it's 1-1. Maybe next time you need to draw points.
Just one more comment. I know how close you and Thierry are. You support each other. You're in each other's corner. How difficult is it to play each other in a magnificent final like that?
Yeah, it's not easy because we're close friends. We always stay together. We share the room together. No sex together. Huh? Just friends. We talk about sex, but no. He's been a great guy for me. I appreciate what he did for me. He was a really big boost for my career. I'm really thankful to all the things he brought in my life, in my game. So thanks for everything. Thanks, Thierry.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Dunlop British Open champion 2007, Gregory Gaultier. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to bring on court to make the presentations and the speeches. First of all, Paul Walters, the tournament director of the International Sport Group. Jackie Robinson, the president of England Squash. Eamon O'Rourke, the Director of Leisure at Manchester City Council. And Toby Marchand, the Indoor Group Marketing Manager of Dunlop Slazenger. And the first presentation, ladies and gentlemen, goes to the tournament referee, Wendy Danzy. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to hand over to Paul Walters, the tournament director.
First of all, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your fantastic support, not just for today, but throughout, I think, what hopefully you'll all agree has been a marvellous event. I would like to say, obviously, events like this aren't possible without the support of a lot of different companies. I'd like to thank, in particular, Dunlop, Manchester City Council, North West Regional Development Agency, UK Sport, and also England Squash for their fantastic support, along with also Ziad Al-Turki for his contribution, not just for this, but for his general contribution for squash. What I would also like to do is to make some personal thank yous. Yes, we need the companies, but we also need the individuals. 3 years ago, when we first took the event, and we worked with England Squash. I was very privileged to work with England Squash, and Jackie Robinson at the time as England Chair showed a lot of drive. We worked very well together, I hope, and I hope you would agree. And I think Jackie has led England Squash through a very difficult period, and I think England Squash have come out of it very much the better. So on a personal note, Jackie, thank you very much for everything you've done for squash, and in particular England Squash. The lady who has taken over, Jackie, is just as able, just as much vision. And I think already in a very short space of time, Zina Wooldridge has made a huge contribution to the sport in this country. And I think the sport is in good hands. So again, Zina, thank you very much for all the effort you've given me and all the support you've given the sport in general. We're very privileged to have in the room the great Jahangir Khan, arguably the greatest squash player of all time, 10 times British Open champion. And we will be giving you an opportunity to show your appreciation for him in a few moments. What I would like to do, though, is I'd like to say a real huge personal thank you to one person who I think has probably touched everyone in this room. He led the country, led this sport on court with distinction for many years, and that's Jonah Barrington. Unfortunately, Jonah can't be with us today. He has unfortunately been quite ill, but we understand that he's making a full recovery. And what I would like to do, I think, on behalf of everyone, is to recognise in a small way the huge contribution that Jonah Barrington has made to this event, also to this sport, and hopefully you will all have the opportunity in Liverpool in May to show your appreciation when he's at that championships. And we can all say a huge thank you to a great man and to a great player. Thank you.
Thank you, Paul. I'd now like to hand over to Jackie Robinson.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of England Squash, I would just like to say a few additional words of thanks. First of all, to the Manchester City Partnership Events Team, to the many referees who have worked so hard this week. I believe you put in some very long hours. But an event like this would never take place if it wasn't for all the many volunteer help that we have. It's wonderful to see you all, and our thanks. I would also just like to pay tribute to my own England Squash events team under Chris Nutley. He's done a great job this week, particularly with the Masters, where I gather we had a record number of entries. Last, but perhaps no means least, our thanks to Paul and the iSport marketing team. They've done a great job. I'm very pleased that we put it in your hands. We have no regrets. But to you all, our sincere and grateful thanks.
Thank you, Jackie. And now pass over to Eamon O'Rourke.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this fantastic facility, which of course was the pride of our 2002 Commonwealth Games. A fantastic legacy to a major event. And one hopes that London 2012 will look at venues like this and the events that we're holding like today as an example of good practice. I too would just like to thank the venue staff, the catering staff, our events team in Manchester, and of course the volunteers. Without that, a world-class event such as this couldn't take place. One of the prides we have in Manchester is to make sure that events like this also give a legacy. We have a year-round programme of squash development. Over 6,000 young people take part in that. And they can aspire to be the best in the world, or they can play at the local leisure centre. That's really important for Manchester, investing in our future. That programme is headed by Nick Taylor when he isn't winning championships here, so that will continue. We've also committed to events 2008 next year, and we're looking forward beyond 2008 to major events, major squash events and other sporting events in the coming year. So I look forward to seeing you all back here, and I hope you've enjoyed yourself. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Eamon. And as they say, finally, a word from our sponsor.
Thanks, Andrew. First of all, on behalf of Dunlop, congratulations to both Rachel and Gregory. I'm sure you'll agree, all the finalists today put on fantastic performances and treated it to some truly brilliant squash. It's also the third year of the Dunlop British Open, and it's been a three-year wait to be able to hand the prize to a Dunlop player. So thanks very much, Gregory, for making that possible. From a company point of view, Dunlop's very proud of its status as the world number one squash brand, and it feels it's very fitting to be part of the British Open. You often hear the players talking about it, you heard some of the people talking about it before. It's certainly a tournament which the players hold up as being second only, if anything, to the World Open, but really a title that all the players want to win. So Dunlop's very proud of being part of this as an event. In terms of thank yous, as is always the case, iSport Marketing, Manchester City Council are just two of the people, as well, of course, as England Squash, who needs to be thanked for putting on such a fantastic event. Last thing to say is to thank you all for coming. Thank you for supporting the event, and we look forward to seeing you at next year's Dunlop British Open in Liverpool. Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed, Toby. Paul Walters mentioned the next gentleman that's going to come onto the squash court in his thank you speech. I mentioned him in my intro. Ladies and gentlemen, he's the greatest squash player of all time, and I say that with respect to all the other great squash players that grace these squash courts. He's 10 times British Open champion. Ladies and gentlemen, he is now the president of the World Squash Federation. Will you welcome and show a warm appreciation for the great Jahangir Khan? And now, ladies and gentlemen, for the presentations, to present the women's trophies. First, the runner-up from Malaysia, Nicole David. And the winner and the women's champion in the Dunlop British Open Manchester 2007 from Australia, Rachel Grinham. As is customary, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like the champion to say a few words, which I'm sure she wishes to. Thank you.
I've actually been wondering whether I should be making my retirement speech now. I don't think I can get much better than that. Just on behalf of Whisper, obviously there's a few important thank yous to make. They've all been said a few times already, so I'll do it pretty quickly. Firstly, I'm going to say a big thank you to Paul from iSport. He's done a fantastic job over the last couple of years in working to build this tournament back up to the level that it should be, that we all expect it to be. It's been getting bigger and better over the last couple of years, and we really look forward to coming back over the next couple of years. Great job. Thank you, Paul. And obviously to the sponsors, Dunlop, the title sponsor, and the City of Manchester, England Squash, all the supporting sponsors. Everybody who's been involved with the tournament in one way or another, it's just been an awesome event, and now I can look forward to coming back and having another hack at a fourth title, hopefully. Thank you.
Thank you, Rachel. And now for the men's event, the runner-up in the Dunlop British Open in Manchester 2007, Thierry Lancou.
Thierry's taken the socks off just for the presentation. Very nice.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the winner and the men's champion in the Dunlop British Open Manchester 2007 from France, Grégory Gaultier.
What a great moment for Grégory Gaultier to get the trophy from Jahangir Khan. What a fantastic moment. And let's hear from Gregory.
Ladies and gentlemen, now I'd like to hand over to our champion just to say a final word to you.
Yeah, I nearly broke the trophy. Sorry, Paul, if you have to buy another one. It's unbelievable, I think, to have... my name on this trophy, it's a very big achievement. I hope, Thierry, you got the world, I get the British. Maybe we can switch one day. So first of all, I'm really thankful to Paul and all the volunteers and the workers who did a great job. I know next year it's going to be the World Open, so I hope you guys are going to come to support the event. I'd like to thank the sponsors as well, because without them, I don't know which kind of job we would do. So thanks so much. And there's a few thanks. Thanks to my physio, who came the whole week. Pierre and Mathieu, they had to leave yesterday. I'd like to thank my coach, André, who is not here, but I'm sure he's watching. And thanks my friends who support me and who's been watching on PSA Live tonight. I received already many texts, so thanks for my friend from Aix-en-Provence and from Lille as well, my girlfriend and my family, and thanks to the sponsors, thanks Toby for the contract, and ISB and Adidas, and maybe a few more sponsors if you're interested, so... No, I'm kidding. So thanks so much. Thanks for everything. Thanks for coming as well.
A lovely moment for Grégory Gaultier.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's it for 2007. We hope you've enjoyed the evening. I'm sure you have. We've had some fantastic squash. You've been a fabulous audience. Thank you very much indeed. Come and join us in Liverpool 2008. And don't forget the fact that the high-tech World Open Squash website opens tomorrow. And have a safe journey home. Thank you and good night.
Well, as Gregory and Thierry have a few pictures taken together, they're good friends. Thierry's got a big smile on his face. I think if he was to lose the final to anybody, he'd want it to be to Gregory. Thierry has yet to get that famous trophy in his hands, and at 31, and with youngsters coming through like no tomorrow, some of the young Pakistanis, Omar Massad from Egypt and Ram Yashour, some people think he's going to win it for a good period of time. This might have been Thierry Lancou's best chance to take home a British Open title, and it wasn't to be. He's smiling away, but He's being asked whether he wants to be in or out of the picture. Well, it was nice for Greg to give us a little mention in the speech. We don't get that too often. As the pictures are being taken, and as that happens in the background, here's a chance for us to look at what tournaments are coming up here on PSA Live. Peter is off to Malmo in a few days. We're going to have day passes available from the Nordic Junior Open. We'll be covering all the matches on the main court in Malmo, Sweden. And then, well, we've got Jahangir Khan on court there. Janshir Khan will be making a comeback at the London Open. And if he does, he's due to play Scott Hanley in round one. If he does play, then we'll be there to cover his return. Omar and Pete will be over at the Saudi International, October the 23rd to the 28th. Biggest prize money event on the tour. And of course then there's the real big one, the World Championship in Bermuda, November the 25th to December the 1st. And finally, I'll be in Sheffield for the Mammoth English Open, which is December the 15th to the 18th. I also hope to spend some time in Hong Kong, provided we can get everything arranged. It's a pretty big tournament over there every year. Well, the photographers fight over the best space possible. There's going to be pictures galore of this scene with Gregory, a very happy man. Well, it's been a pretty hectic day. It got a little bit busy at around 8 o'clock, didn't it? And apologies for those who had a few problems online. We streamed very well for most of the occasion. We just had to reset the server on one occasion, but I think everything was pretty good overall. And apologies, there's usually 5% of people out there who do have problems. That's your problem in connecting to our server, and there's not a lot we can do about that, I'm afraid. There's a few good tips on the forum. But do contact support, and we'll try our best to make sure that your viewing is as good as it can be for next time. It was incredible to see so many people on the chat room. It's fantastic to see so many names and so many new names of members as well. And we'll, as a lot of you disappear off into the night, we're gonna call it a day here. We've got a busy time to pack up now, and we'll just say well done to Gregory Gaultier on taking the 2007 British Open title. And we'll be back in about 3 or 4 days' time from Malmo. Friday, Saturday, Sunday this week, all the matches from there. A lot of the top European juniors will be playing at that tournament, and we'll be there covering the event. Well, my name's Adrian Battersby. You didn't hear much of me because Gwen Bryars was fantastic on commentary. And many thanks for Gwen, who gave us some great insert and great viewing there. Ex-world number four himself, ex-British Open semi-finalist. I'm going to go off into the Manchester night, and we'll see you again soon. Hope you enjoyed the coverage. Good night from Manchester.